Welcome to Greenhorn Linux. Linux for Greenhorns.
On this episode of Greenhorn Linux, Adam shows you how to comment out configuration files. Say what? He even shows you how to use a text editor via the command line. Great, not the terminal again.
So if you're new to Linux and you're trying to modify a configuration file and you're on a forum trying to figure out how to do this, people may suggest in the forum to comment out a particular line in that text file. And you're going to be like, what the heck is commenting out? How do I do this? It's very, very easy, but if you don't know what that means, then it can seem kind of daunting. So I'm going to go through and show you how to comment out text files. It's super, super easy, and I'll explain some advantages to why you may want to do this. So again, I'm going to do this in the awesome Windows Manager. If you're in Ubuntu, the Unity desktop environment, you should know how to get to your terminal and your home folder. So what we're going to need is we're going to need both. So start up the Nautilus file system and a terminal. So first thing we need is a file to play around with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work right off of last week's episode, and I'm going to use the copy command. So the first file that we're going to play with, I don't want to mess up, so I'm going to actually just copy this into my home folder just so we can play around with this. So just invoke the copy. It's going to be in the etc folder, and it is going to be the apt, and it is going to be something called the source lists, and I'm just going to copy that into my home folder, and we will call this demo.list, I guess. Okay, so now you can see that I have this demo list in my home folder, so now we can play around with this folder and not mess anything up. Now, it's important to note that this file, this configuration file, actually dictates where your repositories and stuff come from, so this is just an excellent one to just fool around with. Okay, now that we have this file, we can open it up with a text editor. Now, by default, Ubuntu 12.04 comes with gedit, which is the default text editor. If you've installed other text editors or other desktop environments, you can open them up. I'm just going to use the default, which is gedit, and this is what comes up. So, this probably looks very confusing, but you'll notice right off the bat we have something that looks interesting with these pound signs. Now, it's these pound signs that actually are the comments. So every program language has a place where you can put notes or comments. So this is the way it works. If you want something to not be invoked, then you, in this language, or for configuration in most Linux stuff, you would actually just put the pound sign. So this means that you can either write a note or you can tell it not to be invoked. So for example, right now it's looking in this area for any kind of files for updates, right? Well, let's say I didn't want to look in that area. Well, I could go through, like last week's video, I could create a copy of this file, and then I could just restore it. But let's say I just wanted to not delete this out, right? So if I wanted to have this not be looked at, I could very easily delete it. Gone. Great. Fantastic. But what happens in a couple of months? I'm like, oh, you know what? I shouldn't have deleted that out. I don't have a backup of that. I can't remember what I did. Well, instead, what you can do is you can put a pound. And that basically means now that that is commented out, and it basically means that this will not be looked at for updates. And if you wanted to, you could even do another one and write a note saying, I commented this out on blah 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 date, and this is why. So this is fantastic if you want to get rid of part of the what something isn't looked at, and but without deleting it. Now, if you're doing this with a lot of configuration files, you may want to put a date. You want to may have like a nomenclature. For example, now I've gotten into the habit of always doing the year first, followed by the month, followed by the date. I think today's the 30th. And what's nice about this is now, if I am looking to find something, especially if it's a huge text file, I can say, well, I know in 2012 something was modified, and then I can go through and see everything that I may have commented out in 2012. If it were 2011, I could do the same thing. And then I could say, oh, you know what, I know it was in November that I commented this out, I think, and immediately I am drawn to that line. So whatever scheme you want to come up with, you can think of clever ways of how you want to quickly find some of the stuff that you may have changed. Okay, so now I'm going to go, you're not going to have this file. This is actually a bash script that I created to convert my movie files, which I no longer use, but I still have this. And I just want to show you commenting out like a bash script kind of thing. And I am going to open this up with gedit again. And what's nice about this is I could, like, let's say, this means nothing to you, I'm not going to go through this, but let's say all of a sudden I didn't want to make this directory. Well, with bash, what's nice is it immediately goes purple, because that's how I have this set up. So that way, anything purple for this language is a comment, so I can quickly find anything that may have been commented out. So now I am no longer going to make this directory, but if I ever wanted to restore that, all I would have to do is just simply do that, and boom, it immediately will now make this directory. So that's what's mean by commented out or uncommenting a particular line in a configuration file. Now, I'm actually going to show you another language. This is Lua, which is another language. This is actually what the awesome Windows Manager uses, is a Lua file. Now, commenting out in, and you can see I've got, this is actually how I'm running the awesome Windows Manager. And again, later on, once I get time, I'll do better videos about the awesome Windows Manager. But Lua uses a different commenting scheme. Instead of using pound, you are going to use dash dash. So you can see I have like tons of notes. You can see I've actually commented, instead of, for example, this is a different layout. All of these were commented are the default. So it actually came with like 10 different ways that you can display Windows. Well, I didn't like all of them. So instead of deleting these lines out, I just simply commented them out. So I just put two dashes in front of everything. And you can see I've written myself notes. You can see I added this back in March to start Chrome. So commenting out is very, very useful to keep track of everything that you are doing and to remove and add lines without actually deleting them. So pretty much all configuration files and bash scripts use the pound sign, number sign, hashtag, whatever you want to call this symbol to comment out files. So I would say that in most Linux stuff, you're going to use that symbol probably 99% of the time. It's just for other languages or other scripts that you may use other symbols or other ways to comment out. But for most configuration files, you're just going to use that symbol. Okay, and the last thing I want to show you is how to use your terminal as a text editor. So basically, there are two options. One of them is not installed by default. Well, there's more than two, but the two most common I see are one called Vim, which is not installed by default. A lot of people that do a lot of coding really, really like Vim. I've used it. It's very, very good. I just don't do enough coding to actually make it worth my while for the steep learning curve, but definitely check it out. See if it's for you. The other one is called Nano. So what we'll do is we'll get the manual on Nano. This is installed by default for Ubuntu, and you can learn all about it through the manual. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually open up our demo text file with Nano. So just make sure you're in your home directory that has your demo list, and I'm just going to list that out, and you can see demo list showed up. So now all you have to do is say Nano demo list, and this is it. Now we can edit the text file right in our terminal. Now, probably wondering, Adam, with gedit and other text editors that are graphical user interface based, why in the world would you use this? Well, if for some reason you are messing around with a configuration file and you cannot get back into your graphical user interface because a configuration file you messed up, and then all you did was just comment out a line, and all of a sudden Linux isn't properly starting because of something you did, as long as you can get back into a terminal or rescue mode during the Linux boot up, then you could just open up Nano and you could uncomment out that line if you remember, or you think which line kind of messed up your system, and restart, save it, and you should be right back to where you started. So, again, I usually don't use this. I prefer gedit or a graphical user interface text editor. But I like to know how to do this in case I do mess up something with my boot up. So this is very, very, very helpful to at least know how to sort of use this program. So again, it works just like a regular text editor. I can just, you know, put in my comment out and add lines just like you normally would. And this is a note. So what you'll notice down here is this tells you how to do certain things. So the little caret icon there, that basically means the control button. So if I wanted to exit, I would hit control X. And then if I wanted to cancel that, I would hit control C. If I wanted to justify this, if I wanted to write out, again, this is all in the manual. If I wanted, let's see, control T to spell. Spell checker failed to invoke spelling. Bad file. I have no idea what that error is. I'd have to Google that to figure that out, but I'm sure it's an easy fix. But let's hit control X and we'll exit out. And right now I'm back into the terminal. So again, I don't use it that often, but it's great to be familiar with that. So that way, during boot up, if you need to restore or fix anything that you may have mocked up, you know how to do that. All right. Well, hopefully you found this video helpful. As always, be sure to check out my website, greenhornlinux.com. Thanks for watching.